Okay.
All right. I guess I'll... So you have different spaces, and spaces are essentially tied to a Google account if you want it to. So, for example...
Pause.
Yeah.
You went from super excited to tell me about this to bored. You're awful at content. Just tell it. Yeah. Pretend she's doing this. Forget she has a camera in front of you.
Well, I'm not excited anymore because I'm like, I'm repeating back what I already told you.
Okay, so popping in for 1 second before you get into the full video, just wanted to mention that we weren't sure if we were even going to release this video, so please bear with us on the audio quality. There's some things going on in the background and also the filming quality, but there is so much great information that we really did want to put this out there. So we hope you enjoy it.
Part of this is to understand the spaces component. So essentially you have like your personal space set up. So this is what I have like Telegram, I have some stuff like personal YouTube and podcasts and whatever else.
Do any of those have the shortcuts gone? The shortcuts were pretty cool.
So like my calendar does, for example. So essentially any of the upcoming appointments would show up here on my personal calendar specifically. If I had Gmail here, but I use Superhuman, so it's not gonna do that. But I would show you emails that are coming through. You have folders, and folders are kind of the premise. Like once you're in a space, you have folders. And so, for example, you could just do like a to-do thing, or you could go in and have like a bunch of subfolders. So like I have stuff with medical, I don't really have this, but I have like finance and investing. So then I have like compound, gelt, personal capital, stuff like that, all accessible in this area. And then if you go into these little like micro projects of like learning muscle memory. So when I was learning keyboard layout, then I actually have like all of the Reddit posts in prior days of when I was posting. So every day I posted. So in a way, it's like I'm bookmarking all these pages, but they're kind of just like hidden and to the side, but I can easily jump in and see the whole history of my progress through in one place in an organized way. Whereas bookmarking that in Chrome would just
doesn't work.
It would just be
so you're getting a full-fledged file system organizing your individual tabs.
Yeah. So then if you want to, at any point, you can essentially click the three dots here and you can say, turn this folder into a space. So say, for example, you are getting to a point where you're like, I thought this would start as a folder, but now it's turning into a project. Yep. You could essentially do that and it would pop open a new space. I'm just going to jump into like a work section. So I have work and you'll see that the favorited apps switch over here. So when it was personal, it was more personal related stuff. And now it's more work apps. So you have like Slack and you have Harvest and Help Scout and Asana and all that stuff. So this is my kind of general area for work. So I have like stuff with software, OpenAI, just links to various things like OutFunnel, Motion, whatever. But then I start going into more granular where I have a web development workspace. So you can see I can go to the depths on web development. I'm actually kind of working in web development stuff here. This is kind of for the today view. And I'm just going to say clear this out because I'm not working on it anymore. But under web development, I have like analytics here. I have landing pages, billing, design assets. So you can essentially just hide all of this or you can go in and make it like larger. They also allow for like searching within a folder. So say for example, I don't want to jump in yet. You can just hover over the search area. It will show you the most recently opened things or you can just search specifically within here. So if I do like web.
Gotcha. So not only do you have the file system, you have global search to save you time.
Yeah. So you also have granular search within this to do that. So this is like web development. And so you might relate with this when you're writing blog posts and stuff like that. So this is all about like, I am writing the Efficient VC blog. And then the nice thing with this is like, this is where the split view is nice. You can bookmark split view. So for example, the thing that I'm using, it's like in Markdown and then it's the preview. So I can be writing stuff in here and then I can save it and then I can refresh on the right-hand side and I kind of have that side by side. But the point is I could jump from one tab into multiple tabs, even three tabs. And you could do it vertical, you could do horizontal, everything like that.
For everything that you need to work on that specific project.
Yeah, so you'll see that I have like drafts here and then I have published ones here and then I'm essentially gonna make a longer list of all the published stuff and just easier to jump through all that.
That makes sense. Okay.
And then you can start going into the admin like reconciling side of things. So under like reconciling, you can see bank transactions within QuickBooks.
Yeah.
Documentation, this is where it gets really powerful. So you can essentially take ClickUp or whatever you're using for documentation and you can essentially just pin that. So the point is like, I'm gonna be reconciling, cool. Well, here's how you do that. Here's the edge cases that come up great, I'm going to do receipt matching now, so I need to be within Divi and where the receipts are coming in. So I'm now having multiple websites open at the same time when I'm working one specific workflow. And then automations that work within that as well. Banking, Yelp, Mercury, billing, these are all the billing things or the invoices when I'm working through different invoices with customers. So you could be outside of like all of this and you could essentially just be like, I'm gonna do new tab and I'm gonna say reconciling. And literally I click enter and it opens the folder of reconciling. So now you're almost building these like workflows of structures within the folders and you could jump to them. So it's kind of like, this is almost an operating system that you're interacting within.
And you'll be able to share, so you could have a new team member on board and give them a space and say, this is everything you need to do this job based on somebody else who has.
And you tie in the documentation with it. So it's almost like, so you're using ClickUp for everything.
Yep.
This will allow you in a way to use different tools if you wanted to, but organize them in a way so the structure is actually Arc. And then that's where even the
point and everything else is built into it because it is truly your browser. So if you do have something built within your project management tool, you can have it there.
Yeah.
But for each process, that's the problem with having 800 applications that everybody has to use at every company. You can organize those applications together into folders, function, and structure so that everybody can be on the same page. And since it's savable and it'll be shareable to team members, you can just be like, hey, I'm now going to onboard you on how reconciliation works. This is everything you need to know. I can share this.
Same with like CPA. Like envision a future where everyone is using Arc and now it's like your CPA is using Arc. You can literally share your reconciling folder with them. And then you make tweaks to your process or you add, now we're using Divi. That's just a bookmark in there that's shared with them and now they're updated and they actually have the direct link to everything they need to access because everything really is a web app at the end of the day. So then the stuff, that's kind of the way that all this functions, and you can do stuff with like sales. So just think of this too, like when Andre and I are jumping on a call with a customer, as long as it is in this folder, it's almost like, shoot, the meeting's starting, I just need to go to this folder, and she already set it up, and everything's right there where I need to see it. We might open up their record within Confer,
we might have beforehand,
their documentation, all the things like that. Even the part that gets really exciting is like, what if our customers are now using Arc? Can we build out a documentation and workspace that their team needs to work within a certain division? And can I share that with them? And they can make updates or we can make updates and it automatically gets pushed over to them. And then that is where it becomes more collaborative, where we can use it with our customers. So that's kind of the gist of a lot of that. All the stuff up here is more actively running. So if I were to say click into Superhuman, it's going to already be open. The stuff in here is only going to be open. So if I open this one here, like I'm going to go into something that's not like a huge deal. So if I jump in here and to say Substack, see it's open and it has the little minus sign. So if I do close this, it closes it. If I click X again, then it deletes it. But if you do undo, it comes back. So it's not like, it's very slick in like it's open or it's closed or you want to actually remove it and then kind of undoing that type of thing. And whatever. So
all in all, you have a file system for your internet life. You have a project management system for your internet life. You have the ability to team management capabilities to share back and forth. And because it's completely scalable to you, you can have it at the level of simplicity or complexity that you want, depending on what you're currently working on.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
All right. Yep. All without having the 400 tabs open, just shut down your computer.
Yes.
Because they're all stored in state.
Yeah.
Makes sense to me.
And then, so the whole thing is like, you might, throughout the day, you might just be working within the tab structure that you have here. Or if you're, for example, like, cool, they have a lot of keyboard shortcuts. For example, if I want to duplicate the page I'm on, they have a shortcut that you can set. So I command shift D, but it like just like duplicates it. And I can essentially move stuff around or visit a different page or bring it to like a different space and work within this. And then the nice thing too is like, actually this is one of my favorite features. So let me just go be organized for a second. So let's say, for example, I go to the blog here. So this is like, the page I have bookmarked is my ideas for the blog. So if I jump in and I start navigating away, essentially off the link that was bookmarked. So what happens is it essentially just does a forward slash to show you you're not on the page that was pinned. So you can do one of two things. You can click the three dots and say, I want to replace the pinned tab with where I'm currently at, or just say, I'm gonna reset this back. So I wanna go back to where this was. So now envision that you have like five things open and you're navigating away and then you're like, shit, I just need to reset everything. You just go through, click there, and it just resets everything back to the way that the space was. because I think it's easy to start getting sidetracked. You're in email, and then you click out, and you're on a different website, and you're doing all this stuff, and you're like, what was I doing? And you're like, oh yeah, I was reconciling, so let me literally just go back here and just click home, or back, and you're back and reset. So you can reset the environment in that way.
That makes sense, because it's easy to get distracted and start using it like a regular web page.
Yeah. So this helps you do that. If you do want to just do like throwaway stuff, so for example, like I'm say watching YouTube and I have this open here and you know you have a bunch of YouTubes open, then you can essentially just like, I'm going to clear this out. Whatever tab you're on, it won't clear that out just because it figures that you don't want to get rid of it. But then say that you are playing a video. So the video is playing here. And then if you leave the page, then it's like, well, you probably want to keep it open.
Cool. Yeah.
So then this is
just
where...
Just like your phone.
Yep. So this is essentially where you can, you know, drag it to be large, small, whatever. And even if Arc isn't open anymore...
I think you just killed half of the second monitor companies in the world for all of the developers watching Netflix while they're doing work.
Yeah. But it's just like the robustness of even like being able to go back 10 seconds, 15 seconds. They put a lot of thought into like, even if you wanted
to... What are they doing to that cat?
I don't know. But like, they're just putting a lot of thought and care into each facet of this. So let's say go back to tab. It's going to bring me back to the work that the space that I was in. But then you can go into like music, for example. And then this is where, additionally, they're going to build all these little apps on top of it. So I'm going to play some music. And then when the music's playing, I'm going to leave the tab here. So I'm like, now I'm in my workspace. Then it's like, well, music's playing. So it pulls in the bottom left-hand corner here. So then it's that scenario, too, where you're like, where the hell is that music coming from? You can literally be here and you can mute it.
Even better, no longer need if you have the 2019 unfortunate Macs that had the stupid touch bar.
Mm-hmm. Yes. It's essentially like the
touch
bar is right there.
A more context-specific version of it. Understood.
And then if you have multiple things, I can't really do or think of what to do, but like if I had YouTube music open, also I guess like Pocket Casts or something like that, so then I'm also playing Pocket Casts on top of that, then it just does a good job at
audio, you know, video.
Yeah, like you're playing this, and then if I also had music playing here, then it should, yeah, like this lets you jump between them, or it stacks them like that, right? So then you can even be like, well, I want to listen to this at this volume, and I want this one to be at like this volume. Like, it's just, it goes to that level. I don't know why you'd really want to do that, but it's just more, they can build all these little apps on top of Arc. And then, you know, the whole split screen thing too is just really nice where you're like, I'm here and I'm working within this, but now I just want to drag this so I have these side by side. Or like, you know, I also want this over here too. You can do that.
Okay.
Yeah.
And all then right.
They just have like shortcuts for being able, or I guess you could even just use this. So it's like, I want to get rid of this. I actually want to, you know, grab this and have this be on the left side instead of the right. So they're almost like, can you just make this full screen and you work within this versus having windows next to each other? And then the Alt S is just nice for like, I want to see this or I don't. So if you really, like when I'm, for example, typing, so command 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 jumps you between the different spaces. But like, let's say that I want to be typing, I want a full screen just to be more immersive, which is easy as command S. So this is like a shortcut that I get very, very used to. There's not really anything else to show.
So how does somebody who's excited get started with it?
So if you just go up and I think it's arc.net, you can go throw your email in and it'll put you on the wait list. There's a lot of people on Twitter that are giving away, you know, I think each person can give away 5 invites a month. So if you just ask someone on Twitter, they'll probably, you know, give you that.
Okay, so get yourself on wait list or troll Twitter, your choice.
Yeah, exactly. Cool.
2 days later.
Hey David, what are you doing?
Deleting Chrome.
Really? Why?
Because 2 days into using Arc, I'm getting frustrated when I habitually open it, and Arc is just so much better.